Hey there, Benjamin from Loves Data here, welcome back. Today I'm going to show you how to assign value to your conversions in GA4, Google Analytics 4. If you're familiar with Universal Analytics, then you probably know that you can assign a dollar value to each of the goals you configure. But what about GA4? Is it even possible to assign a value? Let's find out. Before we get started, I want to give a quick shout out to my guide to GA4 events. It's a handy resource for learning about events in GA4, including the differences between automatic and custom events, how to collect and customize them, and more. You can find a link to download the guide in the description below this video. Okay, if you're new to GA4, then I want to start by briefly explaining how conversions are configured in your reports. If you've already done this and you're already familiar with GA4, then feel free to skip ahead using the links in the description below this video. To configure a conversion in GA4, you need to start by ensuring the action is available as an event in your reports. Any event in GA4 can then be marked as a conversion. Let's head to Google Analytics to take a look. We're in my GA4 demo property, so let's select Configure. We're now looking at all of the events that have been collected into my demo property. And on the right, there is an option to enable any of these events as a conversion. If the button to enable conversions on or off is grayed out and not available, then it means you don't have edit level permission for the property. If that is the case for you, then you'll need to have your permission increased, or someone who does have edit level permission will need to configure conversions for you. We can see that the event named Scroll has already been enabled as a conversion in our reports. And we can see there is another event named Generate Lead. This is an event I've created to report when people submit their contact details. Let's enable this event as a conversion in GA4. Now, moving forward, this event will be counted as a conversion in our reports. Let's head to Conversions. We can now see Generate Lead is included in the list of conversions. For a more in-depth walkthrough of how to create conversions in GA4, check out my dedicated video, and when you're ready, pop back to keep watching. Once new events have been collected, you'll begin to see the number of conversions that have taken place. And once you're assigning dollar values, you'll also start to see conversion value in this report. Apart from this report, you'll also see conversions in the standard reports. Let's head to Reports. And then Engagement. And then Conversions. Here we can see details for the conversions that were previously configured in the property. I need to highlight that the event revenue we see here is different from the event value we were just looking at. It is a bit confusing, but they are different metrics. So if you're sending e-commerce transaction details to GA4, then you'll be able to make use of the event revenue metric. But if you're sending a value like we are, then this will only be available under Configure and then Conversions. I'm thinking of covering the steps on how to get the event value into this standard report in a future video. If that sounds like something you'd like me to cover, then please let me know in the comments below. Now, let's talk about assigning values. The way you assign values to your conversions will depend on how the event is created. If you've created the event in the Google Analytics interface, then you can adjust the configuration to include a value. Or if you're sending an event using Google Tag Manager, then you can set the value in Google Tag Manager so that it's also sent to your reports. Let's start by looking at the steps to take if you've created the event in the interface. Let's head back to Google Analytics and navigate to Configure. Let's click the Create Event button. We can see the Generate Lead event that was created earlier. Let's select this. And let's click the Edit icon to add a value. We can see the conditions that were previously entered to create a new event when someone views the thank you page on our website. To include a dollar value with our Generate Lead event, let's go ahead and click Add Modification. We need to add two parameters to our event. We need to add currency and value. So I'm going to enter currency for the first parameter. And then for the value, I'm going to enter USD. This is for US dollars, but you can use any of the standard 3-character country codes as the value. Now let's click Add Modification again. And let's enter value for our second parameter. Now we can enter the value of the conversion. For this event, I'm going to enter 50. This will mean each conversion event will be assigned a value of $50. You can enter any value you like for your conversion. And let's save our event. Now when our Generate Lead event is triggered, it will include the value you've defined. Let's preview this using the debug view. I've already enabled the preview mode using Google Tag Manager, so I'm going to head to my demo site. And I'm going to submit the form to trigger the conversion event. Now let's head back to Google Analytics. And let's open the debug view. We can see the events that have just been sent to GA4. We can select the Generate Lead event. And we can see the currency and value parameters have been sent with the event. And we can see the value is set to 50. So that's how you can assign a value inside Google Analytics. But what if you're using Google Tag Manager to send the conversion event to GA4? Let's head to Google Tag Manager to take a look. Let's start by navigating to Tags. We can see there is already a GA4 event tag that fires when any form is submitted on the website. Let's select this tag. We can see this tag sends an event named Generate Lead to GA4. Let's click on the tag configuration to make changes to the tag. We can see there is an existing parameter, but we also want to set a value for this conversion event. So let's go ahead and add a row. Let's name the first parameter currency. And let's enter USD as the value. Again, this will set US dollars for the event. So you can change this to another currency if you like. Now let's add another row. And let's name this parameter value. And we can then enter a value for the conversion event. I'm going to enter 50 as I did for the other conversion we configured inside Google Analytics. We can then save the tag. And you can click Preview to load Tag Assistant and check that the value is sent with the event. Then, when you're happy, you can click Submit to publish the changes to your live website. By following these steps, you'll be sending the event to GA4 along with the value. So this is very similar to what we covered when we assigned a value directly inside Google Analytics. This is sending a single static value to Google Analytics. But what if we want to send different values for different conversion actions? Well, one option is to repeat the steps we've already covered to create additional events, each with its own value. But if you're using Google Tag Manager, there are additional options. These range in complexity. For example, if you have implemented a custom data layer, you could use values from the data layer and pass them to the GA4 tag. Or a simpler method is to use a lookup table. Let's head back to Google Tag Manager to look at this option. We start by navigating to Variables. And let's scroll down to User-Defined Variables. And click New. I'm going to name the variable conversion value. Then we need to click Variable Configuration and select regex table as the type. This type of variable lets us use regular expressions to determine which value to use for the variable. For input variable, I'm going to choose page path from the dropdown. This lets us use the different page paths from our website. For example, if someone views my blog, then the page path would be /blog/. Now let's add a row. For my demo site, I want to report different values if people submit a form on the homepage compared to people submitting the form on an individual product page. However, you can apply this technique to any pages on your website. So I'm going to enter $$. This will only match the home page of my demo site. Then for the output, I'm going to enter 15. Now I'm going to add another row. I'm going to enter $$product/. I'm going to enter 45 as the output. And I'm going to enter a default value of 25 so that people submitting a form on any other page of the website will be assigned a value of $25. Now let's save the variable. And let's head back to tags. Let's select the form submission tag again. And then select tag configuration. Now let's remove the 50, and let's click the variable icon, and choose the conversion value variable we just created. Now let's save the tag, and let's preview our changes. We can now submit the form on the home page. And now let's open Tag Assistant. Let's open Form Submit. Open the GA4 event and select Values. We can now see that the value for the event is $15. Let's head back to my demo site one more time. Let's navigate to a product page. Submit the form again. And head back to Tag Assistant. Let's find the new form submission and select the GA4 event. We can see the value is $45. This means we're using Google Tag Manager to dynamically assign values based on the page someone submits the form from. So that's how you can assign values to conversions in GA4. I also want to mention that this technique can also be used to assign values to any of the events you're collecting into GA4. The only things you need to do differently is skip the step where you mark the event as a conversion and register the value parameter as a custom metric. If you would like to learn more about GA4, then check out my other videos and my GA4 courses. I've included links in the description below this video. Are you going to assign a value to your conversions in GA4? I'd love to know. Let me know in the comments below. And if you found this video helpful, please like it so I know to make more videos like this one. I'll see you in the next video.